अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. Initially, Arjuna was scared. How can I kill my own teacher, professor, college professor? Dronacharya, Kripacharya, although they are called as Acharya, they are like our college professors. Roti, kapda, makan, oriented education they give. They also gave, now also gave. Now, your college professor, he may be doctorate, PhD, and you both are equally ignorant for a spiritualist. You may be in a multinational company CEO, and that professor trained you, both of you are equally ignorant. That is why he is asking, Agyaja Janita Moha Prashtaste Dhananjaya. Clear? Therefore, here he says, just don't be crying. They have gone. All right, they have gone. They were there, you were taking care of them. Now they have gone. Write them off. What is there? That's why he says, Snehat Anyatra Moha Jat. Oh, once I was invited in Breach Candy area in Bombay, a nice rich man's home, marble, granite, etc. He was a little friendly with me, so we were open. He was used to these harsh statements from my side. So there were four photographs and 150 rupees garland. He said, Swami, this is my father. He died last month. I said, oh, I'm so sorry. This is my grandfather. And believe me, I have seen great-grandfather. I was small. And this is his father. Then I asked him, your father, 150 rupees, that is okay. These three, why you waste money? He said, why, Swamiji? Why means that the last man has already taken birth somewhere else and he is going to college. And you are wasting 150 rupee garland here. You better donate it to me. I didn't comment about the father. I didn't hurt him. Only last month gone. We have to be intelligent in our dealings. This is logical. But as I said, you will have to have basic faith in this information. Then only it will work on you. So that is also explained in scripture. Yavad papaistu malinam hridayam. Tavadevahi.
Tavadevahi.
Na shastre.
Na shastre.
Satya buddhi syat.
Satya buddhi syat.
Na sadgurau.
Na sadgurau.
Sadbuddhis tatha.
Sadbuddhis tatha.
That means as long as our hearts are contaminated by inauspicious material desires, you will have no faith either in the shastras or in guru. You will reject both. If your heart becomes decontaminated, then gradually you will start accepting both this. Otherwise, it's not possible. That is why whenever we give mantra, we tell them to come out of four major sins. That will be explained in the subsequent slokas. So one lady came to me crying. So I said, yes, what can I do for you? Swamiji, I'm in tremendous trouble. I said, I understand. Same dialogue I'm hearing from morning 7 o'clock. Everyone comes and tells me that. How can I help you? No, you give me some mantra so that I get rid of all problems. No, but we don't give like that. So she said, then what should I do for getting that mantra? I said, you have to follow certain principles. Yes, pick up. I said, you have to give up meat and fish eating. So you have to give up fish and meat eating. She said, okay, then. You'll have to give up tea and coffee. She said, then you have to give up onion and garlic. Okay. So if you give up these things and then come back to me, then I'll give you a mantra so you can nicely advance spiritually. Then I said, I'm going tomorrow to the US. I was coming here. So I'll see you when I come next. So after 3 months and I returned, I asked my brahmachari, that gentle lady came. She said, after you left, she never came. Achha. Then after 1 month, after my stay there, suddenly that boy told me, Swamiji, I today met that Mataji in Sham Bazaar area. That's a place, marketplace. So did you ask her? Yeah, I said, Swamiji remembered you. What is the position with you? no, I couldn't give up, I couldn't come because we're all grihasthas, didn't get time. That's all right. Then the Swamiji wanted to give you up things. Did you do something in that direction? And she said, I gave up what is very easy. So he said, well, to give up fish is difficult. Maybe you are given up onion, garlic or tea, coffee. No, no, I couldn't give up all the three. But you said, what is easy you have given up? I have given up Swamiji. See, those things are difficult to give up. This is easy for it. So in this way, we have all polluted desires to enjoy here. Therefore, you will have no faith either in the Shastras or in Guru. So it has to be deliberately cultivated very carefully by getting devotees association on a regular basis that will encourage you to take further steps in this direction.
Tasmajyangavaiklavyam Tasmajyangavaiklavyam
Ajnanakritam Atmanah
Katam Tvanatha Kripana
Vartheranscha Te Cha Mam Vina
Therefore, give up your anxiety due to ignorance of the self. You are now thinking of how they who are helpless poor creatures will exist without you. Hare Krishna.
So because Dhritarashtra, Gandhari and Vidura went away, he is feeling, you know, I was looking after them nicely and now I don't know where they are gone. How will they exist? Who will feed them? Who will help them? You know, that was, he said, no, don't bother about all that. Because as I said, it is Isha Ichaya. By Krishna's arrangement, you were looking after them. Now, that time is over. That duty is over. So, now Krishna will take care of them through somebody else. Or if he doesn't want to take care of them, he will simply lift them up. So, therefore, Vaiklavyam, this moroseness, just give up. Why is that? He is explaining next sloka. Kala karma gunadhino.
Dehoyam pancha bhautikah. Katham
anyanstu
gopaye.
Sarpagrasto yathaparam.
This gross material body made of five elements is already under the control of eternal time, kala, action, karma, and the modes of material nature, guna. How then can it, being already in the jaws of the serpent, protect others? Hare Krishna.
Adhina means dependent. Adhina, controlled by. We are controlled by or we are dependent on kala, karma and guna. Kala means time, karma means activity, guna means material modes. Sattvaguna, rajoguna, tamoguna, the three material modes. That means Naraji tells Yudhishthira, we suffer from four disadvantages right now, all of us, top to bottom. Whether animal, beasts or birds or human beings. Four disadvantages. What is that? Number one, I am dehaha panchabhautika. This body is made of five material elements. Merely material elements. It's chemicals. The external body, merely chemicals, made of chemicals. Different material elements. I am panchabhautika. That means you cannot get things done by this material body much. Then the next disadvantage is, it is controlled by time factor, even while we are operating here. That means what? I cannot tell you, in 2014 when I come, I'll take Gita class. Why? I may conk off. I may simply vanish from the scene. We have no control on the time factor. Anyone can go anytime. So nobody can challenge anybody here. How powerful he may be. We are all controlled by time factor, kala. Then we are controlled by karma. Karma means whatever actions we have done in the past that will keep on producing its reaction from one phase to another phase in life. You are not sure what it will bring to you at 60, 65, 70. You're not sure. If you're 20, you do not know what it will bring to you on 30. 30, young man 25, who is a class 1 sportsman or bulging biceps gymnastics, he may suddenly meet with an accident, both legs gone at 30. But he does not know it at 25. He does not know it at 25. And again at 40, what will happen to him, he doesn't know. And 55, some other new problem may come up. Nobody is sure about anything. And uselessly, we are arrogant. Everyone is arrogant here in this world. I have seen, come across. Very arrogant. Ankara. Meaningless. Because you are not sure what you will come across, encounter from time to time. You see. So, we are controlled by kala. We are controlled by time factor. Already, the worst thing is that we have got the body made of 5 material elements. Kala karma. Guna. Guna means, in Gita, Krishna says, Prakriti kriyamanani gunaihi karmani sarvasah ahankara vimudhatma karta aham iti manyate. Our body is forced to act by 3 modes of material nature. Tamoguna, rajoguna and sattvaguna. Sattvaguna means mode of goodness. Rajoguna means mode of passion. Tamoguna means mode of ignorance. What are the symptoms? Sattvaguna, man, very nice. He will be very decent, disciplined, speaking nice language. His interaction with others will be good. He is religious and at times he reads scriptures. He eats vegetarian food and he is very helpful in the society. He gets up early in the morning between 3:30 and 5. And then he does everything to the satisfaction of the Lord. This is sattva guna. Rajo guna means he is a passionate guy. He will like hot food. He will eat non-vegetarian food. He will take drinks. He will relish drinks. And then he is fond of swimming, skiing, skating, you know, putting the boat on the car, weekends. All these are rajasic. And they are very lusty. And therefore very greedy. Why is a man greedy? To earn more and more money. Because he is lusty. So this lust and greed will finish a man. It has finished the whole civilization now. Lust and greed. Rajoguna and Tamoguna. And Tamoguna, these are the Rajoguna symptoms. What is Tamoguna symptom? He is dirty. He doesn't wear clean clothes. He uses foul language. He's always dilatory. He will drag any action he performs. What he has to do today, he will do after 4 days. Or even if he does it perfunctorily. And then he eats anything. We all have some tamoguna. He eats food by the process of push in and pull out. Meaning, he will take out from the fridge, push it into microwave. He will cook only once in a week. Push in and pull out. This is the process in which we exist. So, these are all. And then, he is not interested in God. And then, his interaction is very bad. And the man who is in the mode of tamaha, ignorance, he mistakes good for bad. He thinks good is bad. And the man in rajaha, he does not know to distinguish good from bad. And only the one influenced by sattva guna, to an extent he can assess properly. Only to an extent. Why? Because he is also influenced by this material mode. Sattva guna is material mode. It's material, material nature. It's nothing spiritual. To give you an example of Indian scenario, tamo guna means unreserved second class compartment in a train.